What is going on, guys? Coach O here at the Lion's Den located in Colmar, PA. And in this video, we're going to talk about the three worst pieces of advice I've ever been given when it comes to the gym. All right, guys, so before we dive into what the worst advice given to me was, I just wanted to share some of the people that submitted theirs from Instagram. So if you're not following me on Instagram, make sure you are at Szatstrength. I just put a poll up on my story. I'm going to read a couple. So some of the worst advice that people were ever given is don't do legs, you're gonna gain too much weight. Checking my body type via quiz before starting to train. Not using specialty bars. The idea of dive bombing a squat in order to utilize the stretch reflex. Just go heavy all the time. Don't lift heavy, you'll start to look like a man. High reps, lightweight, for defined muscles. Don't squat to depth, it's bad for your knees. And I'll end with PR or ER. So those are some just submitted by people on Instagram. And I'm gonna dive into one of the first ones for me that just instantly came to my head. And you guys have probably heard other people say this, and we're trying to probably reduce how much this is said and put a different spin on it. But it's that deadlifts are bad for your back, okay? And if you are anywhere educated in the field of lifting, you know that deadlifts are a fantastic exercise for your back when done correctly and programmed correctly and with good technique, okay? So for me growing up, I didn't deadlift a whole lot because I was told that there really wasn't much use for me to deadlift, and also that it would be bad for my back, okay? And looking back, I wish that I spent a lot more time deadlifting early on so that it could have kind of put me ahead of where I'm at today and I wasn't playing catch up so much with my deadlift. So that's the first one. All right, now the second worst piece of advice I had ever received, and this is early on in my lifting career, was that if I want to get strong, I need to max out all the time. And I remember specifically someone who told me to do this. So when I was young and didn't know any better, I would constantly go into the gym and be testing my one rep max. Now in the beginning, yes, I did get some improvement because it was all a novel stimulus to me, right? Newbie gains, didn't really know how hard or how heavy I could actually push. But then I just hit a wall and I kept trying to repeat that, and I was getting the same results of just failing and not getting better. So if you're in the gym, become very good friends with volume, okay, reps, and progressive overload, as well as getting some sort of structured programming. And you can see that there is a structure, right, where you start off with more volume, and as the volume is going down, right, the weight should be going up, and that should lead into some sort of testing phase, but it shouldn't just always be, you know, maxing out every time you go into the gym, okay? That's not gonna get you where you wanna be, so find a good program and a good coach. Now, my third and final worst piece of advice I ever received, and you guys have probably heard this yourself, is that I need to stick with lighter weights so that I prevent injury, okay? And we know that we can lift heavy weights and be safe and keep good health by lifting heavy weights. So a lot of this comes down to the lack of education coming from the person or just the lack of quality programming, okay? If you are managing fatigue properly, and you guys are getting better and progressively overloading that barbell or weight, whatever you're doing, you should be able to get stronger and push heavier weights and be injury free. Now, injury is super nuanced, and I don't wanna get into it, but there's a lot of variables that go into why people get injured, how they get injured, et cetera. But in terms, lifting is pretty safe on the spectrum of injury, okay? There are a lot of things that can cause injury way worse than lifting weights. So if you're smart and you're careful, you should be A-okay. Now, I wanted to keep this video really short, sweet, and to the point. Honestly, there was a ton of really bad advice that I've received over my career, and I just wanted to pick a couple big three that stood out in my mind. But I'm more interested to hear what is the bad advice you guys have received, and I want you guys to put that down in the comment section below. We'll get some conversation going, and hopefully this video will help people progress faster in their lifting journey, or maybe take some fear away from some of the concepts that maybe were putting fear into their mind about lifting, and we can change some brains out there and get the gains. So if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure you guys subscribe, give the video a thumbs up. I really appreciate it. We're gonna be upping the video frequency to about 3 videos per week, minimally. So I'm really excited about that. And if you guys want even more, I would say join the Iron Lions Facebook group. So just type in The Iron Lions in the Facebook search bar and we will add you to the group. It's a great community for form checks, articles, just a, you know, a hub for people that are into strength training. And we're always trying to give back to the community. So join that community, we would really appreciate it. But until then, guys, stay a lean, mean strength machine. I'll catch you guys soon. Peace.